Who is Drew?
Local guy. He's a hustler. He's smart. Kind of erratic at times.
You best figure out how to handle this, because Santa, they don't play.
Hey, look, first, I need you to tell me everything you know about Saint, your boy Leon, and everybody else in that crew.
He's smart, though. He's kind of full of himself in the sense of he's kind of too confident at times. And you shouldn't be confident, but that's part of his charm, in that he's not really thinking about the repercussions of his actions. He's just acting and kind of reacting off of how people feed off of the energy he gives. I think he kind of power trips off. Not power trips, but it does something to him to see how people react to the things he does.
I told y'all who them projects belong to.
Was you even listening to my story?
You should have stopped him.
When I approach a character, I try to find the parallels between myself and the character in the world, and I try to justify everything he's doing. So I guess the character is me in another universe, you know? If I happen to be from South Central and put in a world where I had an opportunity to really make some money, being a drug dealer, selling crack, and then having an opportunity to kind of upscale my business and things I have to do, I kind of just justify it in my mind that makes sense to me. So he's a lot like myself, but you know, I'm living in different circumstances, so my actions are a little different.
It's either we be in business, or you and everybody you know will be gone.
I guess I would say the most challenging thing would be the accent. You know, the 80s South Central LA accent, a lot different than my natural Virginia accent. So falling into that was probably the most difficult thing, I guess. But the easy thing about it would be, in the 80s, a lot of the people that came up to South Central was from the South. So it had a lot of Southern twang in it. So I was able to incorporate some of that into it, but trying to find a comfortable medium.
You know, it's a coming of consciousness movie. It's a teenage story in a way.
It's a blessing to be able to work with him. He was a great guy. I feel like he was a big part of the reason why I got the spot, you know, on the show, because naturally when I go off of roles like this, like these gangster roles or the most intimidating roles, the scary roles, the villain type roles, I don't really look the part. But John is really from, you know, that type of community, and I am too, so I feel like he kind of saw that in me. And even with my accent, he was like, yo, I like the way you put this Southern twang on it, whereas anybody else would have said, oh, that don't sound like, you know, your typical LA accent. So he kind of just saw through, I guess, the typical tropes of what, you know, this thug or this character is, and he saw something in me that was different, that he liked, I guess. So, you know, kind of having his stamp is reassuring, you know, coming into a set on a show that's in its third season, a successful show. It could be intimidating, but, you know, having John there to, you know, support me and back me up kind of just gave me some extra confidence. I mean, all the way down to, like, the week before he died, he was calling me, trying to put me in touch with his publicist. I was like, I already got a publicist. He was like, yeah, you know, I just want to introduce you to the right people, because you're going to need, you know, you're going to need teams, and you're going to need people and relationships to continue to build in this industry. And I feel like you got the potential to do so. So, you know, from the beginning to the end, he was, you know, on my side and there for me. And I feel like, you know, he's going to continue to live on his legacy. They just dedicated a theater to him. Yeah, and people talk, you know, he's become more of a conversation piece since he passed, and it brought a lot more traction around the show. But people was able to see the show and, you know, see what he contributed to it. So, I don't know, he'll live on forever, you know, through his work. Like, where I'm from, I didn't know an actor, knew anybody who knew an actor, so it just wasn't a thing. You know, I could like aliens, but I don't want to be a Martian, you know what I mean? It's just so far-fetched. But I remember when I was probably like 6 or 7, I saw Friday, and I remember the whole movie, like word for word, and I put on a play with my cousins, and I gave all of them like different roles. I was like, are we gonna act this out? My mama let me cuss when we do Friday, so we gonna do Friday. And they was forgetting their lines, they was dropping their lines, so I fired everybody and did the whole thing myself. I remember that. That's probably one of my earliest memories. And I just always enjoyed entertaining on camera. Like in person, I'm more so introverted, you know, to myself, but being able to really perform, I feel like it's kind of like an escape out of myself. So I always enjoyed it. It was my second year in college. I took an acting class just trying to fill my curriculum, but I just really enjoyed it. I really liked it. The teacher kind of encouraged me to, you know, continue to pursue it if it's something I like, because she felt like I was good. So I started taking classes outside of campus. I was like, oh, I like this more than anything else I'm doing, and I feel like it's easy. It's a lot less effort than, not a lot less effort, but I enjoy, so it feels like a lot less effort than studying for history exams and Asian history and just random stuff. that I didn't feel like I would ever really use. So at that point, I was like, all right, cool. I don't mind taking a leap and really chasing what I want to do. So after, you know, taking that class, I was like, all right, I'm gonna put a plan together, figure out how I could, you know, pursue acting. When I was younger, I always felt like I was destined to like be more. I always had confidence to be more than what I could see. You know what I mean? Like, I grew up in the projects like majority of my life. So that's kind of all I saw. That was the scope of my world. It wasn't like an Instagram or something like that where I could, you know, look through the lens of somebody else's life. All I could see was what was around me, but I felt like that wasn't it. It was so much more. I didn't know how I would get to it. I just always felt like I would be successful and influential in a way. I just always felt that way. I didn't know what it would be. I never, you know, aspired to be an athlete or a lawyer or a doctor. I was like, nah, that's not it. I'm not gonna settle. I don't know what it is, but I don't know. I'm gonna figure it out. So I always just felt like that. And I always kind of had an eye for entrepreneurship. So I was like, maybe I'll just be a business person. You know what I mean? Maybe that'll be it. And that's what drove me to all those different business majors. And then once I took that class, I was like, oh, I think this is it. And then just thinking about it, it made sense. Everything made sense from when I did Friday when I was a kid, to me being like 11 years old, being at a party, everybody was dancing. I'm too ashamed to dance. I'm too embarrassed to dance. And we all put masks on. And then I just felt the freedom to do whatever I wanted to do because like Melvin wasn't being judged. From like that to when I was 15, I had like a PlayStation iToy and I hooked it up to a VCR and you could only record 10 second messages. And I would do sketches in 10 seconds, you know what I mean? Just out of like joy, out of fun. My 14th birthday, got a video camera and I would run around just recording stuff, trying to put movies together. And I just always enjoyed it. Didn't really look at it as a career or a way to make money or the way to gain some any type of notoriety. I just enjoyed it. And just other stuff about myself too, being able to relate to different type of people and justify their actions and kind of just study people and observe different things and kind of lose myself in the world I am and escape to other worlds. All of that stuff kind of just played into a career of acting. So once I took the class, I was like, wow, it all adds up. It can't be by coincidence. And that kind of just gave me the confidence to pursue it because I felt like it was, you know, something outside of myself kind of guiding it. What's up? My name is Melvin Gregg. Make sure you check out Snowfall every Wednesday at 10 p.m. on FX.